So now it's time for the summaries and the limitation of the scaling inside Piper application. Scaling workflow, there are several changes as shown in the introduction. Define the target population of subject, extracting information, and define them and link them with the human body model, and apply the transformation to the model. Piper offers a set of tools, flexible tools, to support users in search workflow to scale a model. First, to describe the target, we have the entrepreneurship module for a few number of predictors. We can predict a full set of entrepreneurship dimensions. It could be extensible, but what about combined several data sets? How we can deal with targets far from data sets? What is the plausibility of such prediction? So this is a work to be done to understand how it can work. Regarding body landmarks, so the last presentation from Christophe, we have in principle we have shown that it could work on one subject, but it should be delivered at the end of the project. Will a great improvement. Regarding the statistical shape model of the full skeleton, we could deliver some structure defined during the project. This is more a perspective method to be used inside Piper, but permissions data will be delivered with the Piper release. The challenge is more related to the data, to have access to open data, to be able to build such database and use it in tool developed during Piper project. Overall, improvement is needed regarding more specifically the confidence of the target generated with such tool. Regarding transformation method, we have improved the standard kriging interpolation method in a flexible way. We have some resilience with smoothing adjustment. We have many parameters to play with to have a good shape regarding the deformation. So in that way, we have with the preview, we have an iterative process to help the user to have at the end of this task a shape that can be used to crash simulation. We have also another tool to deform the model, the control transformation, and can be used also in combination with anthropometric prediction. But we need more experience to use this tool in a real case application to understand what can be done in a better way or what we can remove, but it seems promising. Regarding how we can define scaling constraint on a human body model, so we can associate targets with a human body model through the skeletal model. We can combine some internal or external constraints using target landmark and anthropometric constraint in an iterative way, friendly tool for the user and make adjustment of the target. So we fill the gap between data and the transformation method. So for the conclusion, this set of tools should help the user to scale the human body model. But again, we do not impose a workflow or a way to do that. Just we propose some tools, flexible tools. And now this is your turn to play with it and understand and see how we can help you to scale your model. There are many scenarios possible, many workflows already possible. For advanced user, we need some advanced user experience is needed to formalize search workflow. We have specific case shown during the session with a child model. So this is just a figure to see how we can organize several boxes or several steps in the scaling workflow, but we have several paths and to have at the end the scale model. For the perspective of the scaling, we think a cooperation between positioning, so the next session after lunch, and the scaling to be able to adapt the position of limb mainly to the trunk shape, for example, when we enlarge the width of the trunk. We have also some limitations, not due to numerical method, but due to the mesh design. What about event quality when soft tissue becomes very, very, very thin? We have some mesh density, mesh size at the beginning, but when we have a very thin soft tissue, what need some method to either remeshing locally the mesh or have a parametric mesh to adapt the mesh to the local size of the soft tissue, something like that. So this is one of the perspectives. Another limitation is that using occlusion method or contour method, there is no topological exchanges of the mesh. It's not possible. And for all statistical tools implemented in Piper, of course, more we have data, more statistical will be accurate or more adapted to more population or something like that. And more testing will be helpful to understand how we can help users more, again, to instruct your scaling workflow. Thank you for your attention. This is the end of your session.